Hello everyone, my name is Alex. What is the best way of fighting trypophobia, you might guess? I say, try to recreate it. Today I'm gonna show you how to make this shader in Blender Eevee, but not just one, but some variations of it, so by the end of this video you'll get rid of all of your fears. Okay, let's take a dive into world of creepy shaders. We're starting our therapy session with some basic scene setup. I explained it in details in my previous video on how to create realistic skin shader. Take a look if you haven't yet, especially if you're taking your first steps in Blender. I'm gonna repeat some steps from that tutorial to get us closer to a starting point. First we're gonna create a smooth skin material, then we'll take next steps on make it look really disgusting. I've seen people enjoy a lot when I model disgusting things. What can be more disgusting than a realistic trypophobia shader? And guess what, we'll even take it a one step further, we'll make it procedural, so you can enjoy your trypophobia in almost lossless quality. Why I said almost? Because that skin material we're gonna use as a base is using regular image textures. That's one downside of it, but hey, at least they're seamless and we can scale them as we like. I've just joined texture with color, subsurface, and specular inputs of our shader. This color mix node gives us a softer look. I add layer weight node to control softness fall off closer to the edges. Color ramp node gives us better control over fall off curve. We need to connect it with factor input of color mix node. I usually switch gradient mode to be spline because it gives a smoother, more natural transition between control points. Okay, now let's add bump map. I connect mapping node with the texture vector input, change its projection mode to box, and set blending factor to 0.5. Also, don't forget to change bump color space to non-color so it's not affected by tone mapping. I add bump node and connect texture with the shader. Now skin looks way too bumpy, we need to decrease strength of the node. Let's also adjust texture scale so we have higher density of skin pores. Now I go to material properties to enable subsurface translucency. This option makes skin shader look much more realistic. I want to switch preview mesh from Suzanne to a sphere I have prepared previously. Let's give a more appropriate name to this material. Basically, I've just recreated the same shader I explained in my previous video, but this time I'm using different kind of textures, they are much less hairy. Let me quickly show you texture maps I've just loaded. This is a skin color map, and this one is a bump map. They are both seamless. By the way, you can make any texture seamless very easily using GIMP Image Editor. It has a very useful built-in function to do that. Okay, let's go back to the shader editor. In real life, skin doesn't have such a perfect uniform surface. It can have bumps, wrinkles, age-related damage. Let's add some imperfections so it looks more real. Easiest way to do this is by using noise texture. I connect texture mapping node with the noise, this way we can adjust scale of all textures using only one node. We also need color ramp node to control noise fall off. Okay, now let's mix it with our bump texture. I change blending mode to multiply, and set factor to 1. We can see immediately how skin surface became more lifelike. Change noise scale to 8 to increase frequency of bumps, slightly decrease roughness, and increase distortion so it's not uniform. Let's drag this slider to the right to increase contrast of the noise. We can play with mix factor to find the right balance for us. However, right now it looks too bumpy. Seems so distorted it's even off-putting. Remember I told you why I prefer to use B-spline for gradient blending? In real life we rarely can see something blend in a linear way. Now watch what happens when I change gradient blend mode to B-spline. See, it gives so much softer look, completely different story. Very good, our beautiful skin is finally ready to be transformed into something very uncanny and phobia triggering. I know you've been waiting for it. Let's start by adding our first procedural Voronoi texture. Change feature output to smooth F1. And now add color ramp to fine control output of the texture node. Connect distance with the color ramp. We're connecting distance because Voronoi texture initially generates lots of evenly distributed points, and we want to map distance between these points to a gradient to create smooth holes on the skin. Let's also add texture coordinates node. Why we're creating new one instead of reusing existing node, you'll understand in a minute. Now we need to mix this new texture with what we currently have. Add color mix node, and connect color ramp output with the second socket. We want to mix it over existing color texture. Now take output of the additive mix node, and connect it with the first socket. And now let's replace all existing connections to come from the latest color mix node. We already can see some dark spots appearing on the surface of the skin. Let's connect alpha output of the color ramp with the factor input of blending node. We can use same gradient to control blending factor as well. Very handy. Now let's increase Voronoi scale to something like 9.7 so we have more spots. Reduce smoothness to 0.5. Watch closely how randomness is affecting placement of these spots. We don't want them to be completely random. I ran some experiments and found out that more organized arrangement of spots gives extra spice to the trypophobia inducing effect. So let's leave randomness at 0.475. Now all attention to the color ramp. Precision is very important here, so try to type in exact colors and values where I'll be putting control points at. First point, E4 before 9F, alpha at 0.5. Change gradient mode to be spline. Add a new stop. Color 470500. Alpha at 1. Position at 0.168. Add one more stop. Color 950F00. Alpha 1. Position at 0.3. Next stop. FF6565. Alpha 0.033. Position at 0.466. And now last stop. Color B38A7B. Alpha at 0. Position at 0.636. Let's zoom in to check what we have. Looks like inflamed pimples, we definitely need to add some depth to them. Such a good soup. Alright, our next step is to create similar color ramp for a bump channel. But first, let's group what we have so far. I select all these nodes and press Ctrl G to move them into a new node group. Our group will have many output channels, let's open its properties in the top right corner. I'll clear up some space, we'll add more nodes here. Now if we zoom in, these pimples look way too symmetrical, I want to distort them a bit. Let's use noise texture for this. But what we're planning to distort with that noise? Can you believe it? We can also distort texture coordinates the same way you would color data. Let's add a color mix node, and put it in between Voronoi texture node and texture coordinate like that. Now connect factor output of the noise texture with second input of our mix node. It looks way too distorted. Let's set scale to 14 to increase noise frequency. And now reduce blending factor to something very small like 0.033. Awesome, we added slightly more variation and it looks even more realistic and creepy now. Let's get back to the group outputs node. Click on this button to add one more group output. Name it bump. One more, for specular channel. And the last one, for roughness. Okay, let's add one more color ramp, this time we'll use it for bump. Connect Voronoi texture with the factor input of the gradient. And connect color with the bump output of our node group. As usual, I change gradient mode to be spline. Now let's add some gradient stops. First stop, set color to white, position to 0.059. Add one more. Color to black, position 0.173. One more. Color black, position 0.232. Next stop. Set white color. Position to 0.318. Fifth stop. Set color to 7F7F7F. Position at 0.486. And the last stop. Color 7F7F7F. Position 0.664. Now press tab to exit group edit mode. And let's give it a name. I call it Trypophobia. Copy paste this name to the group in the list as well. And click this button to protect it from deleting. Now we can connect it with the bump node we have down there. Funny thing about these node groups, you can easily duplicate them and move around, so we don't have to pull connection lines across whole node setup. So let's do that, make a copy and move it closer to the bump node. Okay, now we need one more color mix node right here in the middle. Connect bump output of the node group with the second socket, and let's change blend mode to overlay. Overlay works best for mixing grayscale depth textures. Increase blending factor to 1. Looks awesome. Now if I zoom in, we definitely need to do something about specular and roughness channels. These holes look too shiny. Let's go back to the node group, select it and press tab to enter edit mode. Well, we need a third color ramp here. Connect Voronoi distance with its input, and let's connect gradient color with the specular channel output. Now, pay attention to the numbers I'll be typing in. First stop. Color C8 to E4. Add second stop. Set color to 470500. Position to 0.168. Third stop. Color 950F00. Position 0.3. Fourth stop. Color FFCDB3. Position 0.364. Last stop. Color B38A7B. Set alpha to 0. And position to 0.475. Nice. Now let's exit the group. Duplicate it and pull closer to the specular input of our shader. Very well. We fixed specular channel and it looks much more natural now. But job is not done yet, we still have roughness channel left. Go back to the group node. And let's add one more color ramp. Connect Voronoi texture with gradient input. And connect it with the roughness output of our group. Now this one will be much simpler. Change gradient mode to be spline. First stop, color 53 53 53, position at 0.064. Second stop, set color to CCC, pause to 0.132. Final stop, same color, position at 0.305. Now exit group and connect our final channel with the roughness input of the shader. Well done. Now you can see that yellowish fluid in holes looks very wet and shiny, but rest of the skin is soft and less reflective. This is what we wanted. Let's switch meshes and test this shader on the Suzanne I have right here. It looks just awesome without any readjustment. Poor Suzanne, but she knew that was coming. Now, you might ask, can we make this even more creepy? Yes, we can. What can be more creepy than a cluster of gooey eyes staring into your soul? Sounds cool, let's do this. I switch back to a sphere we had before. Well, I like this node group, let's keep it and make a copy. To make a copy we need to press this button with a number of users. Not so obvious, but this is the way how you can create a single user copy of some data block. I rename it to something like Trypophobia Eyes. And let's protect it from accidental deleting. But you know what, we shouldn't do it here. I better switch it back and make a whole material copy instead. Before copying, I'll rename our skin material to something more suitable. Trypophobia Skin. Protect it. And now I click this button to make a copy. Rename it to Trypophobia Eyes, and click Protect. Now finally here we can switch node group to use a copy we created previously. Don't forget we also need to relink other group nodes in this material. Now it's very easy to mess up, so pay close attention to which material you're editing. Let me switch between materials, I better check that we did everything correctly. Yeah, as you can see node groups are different now in these. Okay, let's go inside and start editing. We start with a color gradient. Let's zoom in to see better what we're doing. So, first stop. Change color to black, alpha to 1, position to 0.086. Second stop, color to black, position to 0.120. Third stop, color to FFD7C6. Wait a minute, it looks so weird now. Just think of the possibilities if we just changed a few gradient points and got this. Readjust last position to 0.223. Next stop. Color to 82D26. Alpha to 1. Position to 0.277. Last stop. Color to 950F00. Alpha to 1. Position to 0.350. Now let's add a stop. Set its color to FF6565. Alpha to 0.033. Position to 0.595. And one more stop. Color to B38A7B, alpha to 0, position to 0.784. Wow, so awesome. Very creepy, much eyes. Let me drop Voronoi texture scale down to 8.7 so they appear bigger. Reduce smoothness to 0.225 to give them sharper borders. And perhaps increase randomness to about 0.717. Since we're creating eyes now, we want their borders to be rounder. Let's reduce distortion of texture coordinates we added on very first steps. Set it to 0.02. I also slightly reduce noise scale down to 12.410. What else can we do? We have lots of pale skin left. Let's fill up this space with some creepy veins. Add a wave texture and color ramp. Now connect them together. Okay. We will modify only color channels. I move these nodes away to free up some space. We need a color mix node right here. Let's connect this last color mix node as an input of color mixer we've just added. Change blend mode to multiply. Now replace all connections we had before so they go through our new node. Only base color and subsurface. Okay, we start to see something. Let's tweak our wave texture. But first, change gradient mode to be spline. Now change wave mode to rings. Scale to 2. Increase distortion to 30. Detail to 4. Phase offset to 23.1. Set gradient first stop color to 8B004E. Change position of the second stop to 0.464. Now it looks way too sharp. We want to reduce blending factor down to 0.350. Looks nice. So this is our final node setup. Well done. Now how about trying this shader on other meshes we have in our scene? We did it procedural for a reason after all. Let's check first how it looks on our Suzanne. Now she can see world in new colors. But wait, we also have a cube right here. Let me switch materials real quick. These eyes look so nasty, it's giving me chills. And let's not forget about meta balls. These are most suitable for organic modeling. Now that's a next level of creepiness. But anyway, there you go. I hope this was as useful as it was creepy, and you survived our therapy session without any serious consequences. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you want to see more tutorials like this.